I'm sorry, Jeff, it's over.
What?
Hello, Breaker Uppers.
You want to be single by March? Consider it done.
Just because we got gay marriage doesn't mean we need to follow through, you know? I didn't vote for it.
You weren't gay 8 months ago, Russell.
I want a nice, clean break. I don't want years of heartache and stalking and therapy and possible violence.
Love is hard to do. Don't take your love.
Well, The Breaker Upperers is a hilarious new film about two best friends who run a business breaking up couples for cash. Writers, directors and stars, Jackie Van Beek and Madeleine Sami, join us now to tell us all about it. Welcome, you two.
Yes, welcome.
Thanks, guys. Congrats. Thank you.
Obviously, every man and his dog of your friends and well-known New Zealanders are in that. But, Jackie, how did you come up with the idea for the film?
Look, it just actually just came to me one day when I was mucking about in my kitchen.
And
I was having a coffee, doing the dishwasher. And I just was reflecting on all of those conversations that we've all had, you know, with people who they have that dawning realisation that they need to break up with their partner. Yeah. And then I thought, wouldn't it be great if you could just outsource that responsibility to somebody else? And so then I thought it's a good idea for a film. And then rang Madeleine Sami.
Yeah, and what was your reaction, Madeleine?
Jackie and I have been friends for a long time, and we have acted in a lot of things and had, you know, been in various theatre productions and movies and things like that, but we never really had a big thing to sink our teeth into. And the idea of doing a buddy comedy with Jackie, who I think is one of the funniest people in New Zealand. Well, definitely
so
definitely
nice
the top
to
10. Definitely the top,
top 10.
Definitely
top
20.
I'd go top 5.
Top, yeah.
Top
5. Top 2. No order. But I just thought that sounded really exciting to me. And it also, as a writer, I just was like, I could see the endless possibilities of creating a kind of comic, hilarious movie out of this premise. So, yeah, and so there was another sort of 4 and a half years
after that.
In between doing other projects and, you know, living life, and then here we are.
Because movies don't come quickly, do they? And you write and you also direct and you star in it as well. So
that's right.
How logistically does that work for you?
It was all shot on iPhone. That's not true.
But how do you do it? Like, how do you logistically jump from one to the other? Is it difficult? Or do you direct Madeleine? Do you direct Jackie?
Yeah, when Madeleine was in a scene without me, I'd direct. It was simple, and vice versa. When we were both in a scene together, it was a little bit more chaotic. But we used a lot of improv, so we'd do a lot of improv within the scenes. But we had one of our on-set producers, Ainsley Gardner, is a great writer-director. So she kind of stood behind camera and kept us on task in terms of we'd go into wild improv.
She'd just rein us in if we were going
you guys have got it, you guys have got it. We're like, no, we've still got another joke, we've still got another bit.
No one say cut,
because you can't, we're the directors.
That's right, and I reckon you'd be harder on yourself than you would with another actor.
Ourselves extremely funny, so our challenge was to actually stop and move on.
Right.
We didn't have a lot of time. I mean, we had a 4 and a bit week shoot, so it was we were moving very fast, so we couldn't muck around too much.
That's fast, yeah.
But yeah, it was pretty mental making.
And James Rolleston, he's in it, as well as a cast of amazing Kiwis. What was it like working with James? Because clearly it was his first big stint since that awful car accident. It must have been quite overwhelming for him and for you guys.
Yeah, well, we wrote with James in mind, actually, because we just thought he's obviously New Zealand's main movie star. He's like the go-to.
We say he's New Zealand's only movie star.
There's people at home now sitting there going, I thought it was me.
I think it's been like six feature films.
Yeah,
right?
I mean, it's just like there's a couple of movies made every year in New Zealand. He's in both of them.
Yeah.
He's our only
That's
movie
That's a good
star.
Point.
We really kept our fingers crossed that he would want to do it and be able to do it. And he was great. Like the first day he was on set, it was sweet. He was like, I'm so glad to be back.
He was just hugging everyone. And we sort of, obviously, we weren't sure if he'd be ready to come back, but it just timed out perfectly. And
nice.
Ainsley,
he's hilarious.
He's so funny.
And that's
what we were excited about. Like, he came in and just nailed the audition, and we were just like, this guy is so funny, and people need to see how good he is at not only just... He's a movie star with, like, great drama.
Beautiful dramatic actor.
But he's also hilarious.
Very funny.
To look at. Yes.
And you guys...
He's good to look at.
Yeah, he's nice enough.
Yeah, he's good. He's a good bit of eye candy on TV.
Yeah.
He's really good. You guys, though. So you play Jen. Jackie, you play Jen.
I do. She does that weird tone. She gets sort of masculine. But she feels uncomfortable.
Yeah. And Madeleine, you play Mel.
Jackie's a good bit of eye candy.
This is
a nice set. Got a nice bit of eye candy around here.
Listen to the question.
Back over here.
Listen to the question.
Remember? I'm here for this. Just imagine.
Camera
so you play Jen.
Yeah.
Jackie, Jen.
Yes.
Madeleine Mel, obviously, so you can remember your character.
That's exactly why we did it.
Tell us about your relationship, because it's something quite special. It's like a girl... Well, no, what is it?
What is it?
Relationship where you're really in each other's faces, but you've got this love-hate thing going on, haven't
we
you?
We call the relationship friendship. I don't know if you know that. We say that the movie's about a friendship, but you're right, and I'm sorry to mock you on your own TV show. But
thanks for that, Jackie. I've written that down. It will be remembered.
I'll tell you what it's called. It's called Two Ladies
Hanging Out.
I know what you mean. I know what you're getting at. They're two women that were kind of bound together by a rather traumatic event, without giving too much away to the...
They've both been burnt by love.
Yeah, eye candy behind the cameras there.
Oh, no, don't do that voice, don't.
No, bloody eye candy, really. No. Those cameramen, bloody eye candy, I tell you what.
They're in a they're in quite an unhealthy codependent relationship.
That's what I was getting at.
The film. That's right.
That's what you're trying
to say. But then, you know, their friendship kind of blossoms, you know.
And I love the wave of emotion, because I thought I was going to laugh all the way through it, which I did, but it was actually quite emotional as well.
Did you cry? Were there tears? Were there actual tears?
Well, I am a pretty sensitive guy, so yes, there were tears. I don't want to admit that.
It is quite emo. Yeah. Also, what I've noticed is that you can't go half a second in this movie without a cameo from somebody famous in New Zealand. Now, Jackie, you're married to Jesse Griffin.
I am.
He's in it.
He is.
Comedian, he's in it.
He's in for half a second. I pass him behind a bar.
He was actually in for a much longer scene, but we had to cut it. So we got him back in for the pickups.
I did extensive auditions for the bartender pass-up scene, but he did prove to be the best guy.
You insisted on me being that part.
You weren't so good in that part.
No, I also am in the movies.
But there's everybody. You've got Jermaine Clement in there. You've got so many people in there. I mean, how did you get all them involved?
We basically just called up our mates and were like... It was literally like everyone that
we got our
and
producers
loved.
To call up our mates.
No, I called a few.
Oh, did you?
Yeah. I actually did on the morning we did the montage. I had
did
to call
you? You can't do that. There are protocols. You tell the producers.
Yo, Lucy, what are you up to?
Oh, you did actually.
Hey, Lucy, up
to. Lucy Lawless.
Well, tweet Lucy. Hey, Lucy, up
you
to this
to
morning.
You have to go through the producers and the casting
now,
directors.
Now, what you say is
things.
You call and you say, up to.
Oh, right.
And then people will think you're cool.
I see what that means when you do that. I just ignore that because I just think it's a mistake. The pocket call.
And that was a great thing too. Great women power in this movie. I mean, 60% of the cast was women.
A lot of women.
But we had a lot of women in our crew as well. We were 60%.
Yeah, female.
Perfect.
A beautiful.
By accident.
A beautiful cinematographer, Ginny Lone, and you know, going back to how we kind of kept this you know crazy roller coasting circus on target. She was amazing
Girl
in
power.
Terms of when we were in front of the camera, we could totally rely on her to be
to hold the vision,
to hold the vision, you know,
keep it all flying. Hey, well, it's great. It's a wonderful movie, and I really loved it. Really enjoyed it. In fact, loved it so much I saw it twice.
Twice in 1 week. New Zealand.
The Breaker Uppers is officially in cinemas from today. Make sure you get along to check it out.
Well, so much more I wanted to ask, but we're out of time. Go and see the movie. Trust us, you will not regret it.